Hi and welcome back to Goroscan English. Before we get started, a quick disclaimer. The information in this video may not be 100% accurate because I have many sources of information. With that out of the way, let's get started. First of all, what is an ocean? Google says it's a very large expanse of sea. In particular, each of the main areas into which the sea is divided geographically.
What?
Simply said, all the oceans are technically one big ocean, but people divided it to make it easier. Now let's look at the Pacific Ocean. In the west is the Indian Ocean, while in the east, the Atlantic one. You can already tell that the Pacific is the biggest of all the seven oceans. It roughly covers 101,388,672 square kilometers or 63 million square miles. Now, why is it shrinking and shouldn't we be worrying? No, you shouldn't worry because it will take roughly 100 to 500 million years before the entire Pacific Ocean is gone. But how is it shrinking? Plate tectonics. You've probably heard of it before. Continents sit on tectonic plates, slabs of crust that float on the mantle. The mantle acts like a boiling pot of water. Earth's molten core heats the rock at the bottom of the mantle, causing it to slowly rise. Meanwhile, cooling slabs of crust sink in subduction zones to the bottom of the mantle. This circular flow is called mantle convection. And over millions of years, it drives the motions of continental plates and their occasional assembly into supercontinents. Pay close attention to the North American plate. As you can see, it's pushing the Pacific Ocean to Asia. On the other hand, in Asia, it's the opposite. Instead of pushing the Pacific plate, it's pushing it under itself. That's why in that region of the world, there are the most earthquakes and volcanoes on Earth, with big eruptions happening every 50 to 100 years, with ones like the Japan 2011 earthquake and tsunami. Now, what will happen if the Pacific is entirely gone? When that happens, North America and Asia will collide, forming a new continent called Novo Pangaea. But why is it called Novo Pangaea? Well, literally translated, Novo means new. So new Pangaea, that sounds so stupid. A long time ago, all the seven continents were one continent called Pangaea. Do you see where I am going? So, Novo Pangaea is new Pangaea. I won't be around to witness it myself, so we can only think about how it may happen. But before that happens, there will be other supercontinents forming. Like here in Europe, where Africa is going north to slam into Europe. Or here, where Australia is also going to the north, where it will collide with China and Korea. All that will happen in the future. But let's take a step back and look at the past. With a step back, I mean 4.5 billion years in the past. Then the Earth was just born. Oof, that's too much in the past. Let's go 500 million years forwards. Now we see that the Earth is rapidly cooling down. Slowly but surely the continents are starting to form. After 2 billion years, we can slowly see the continents of now being formed. Skip another 2 billion years and we see Pangaea. Fun fact, because Pangaea connected all the continents, some apes from now Madagascar migrated to the Indian subcontinent. A group of scientists were researching the apes of India when there arose a stunning similarity. The apes from India looked astonishingly similar to the apes of modern-day Madagascar. Further analysis showed that there was an ancient ancestor of the two ape species. At that time, the scientists still didn't know that Pangaea existed, so there was one big question lurking around everyone's head. How did apes from Africa migrate to India? First, they thought the long way, via Africa to the Middle East, then to the subcontinent. but the theory was quickly busted because the apes could have not migrated this far. With that myth busted, the scientists concluded that it was a mystery. Years passed by, but still no one cared to find an answer to this, until one scientist looked at a map of Pangaea. There it was. You could see that Africa and India were once connected, so that meant that the apes must have migrated from Africa to India. Earth has seen a few supercontinents come and go in its ancient past. Now, researchers theorize that these giant landmasses form in regular cycles, about every 600 million years. To uncover more about Earth's supercontinent cycle, Ross Michel, a geologist at the Chinese Academy of Sciences, and his colleagues focused on megacontinents, which are smaller than a full supercontinent. One such megacontinent is Gondwana, which formed about 520 million years ago and led to the assembly of Pangaea 200 million years later. They even predict when and where the next supercontinent will form, driven by the creeping flow of rocks in our planet's hot mantle. To study how Gondwana became Pangaea, the researchers mapped the continental plates over time, based on fossils and other deep time records. And they explored how the position of these continents related to the models of mantle flow and the expected location of ancient upwellings and downwellings. They found continents tend to drift downhill towards subduction zones where mantle rocks are cooling and sinking down. Michel calls these zones subduction girdles, because the continental plates, too thick to subduct, go there and get stuck, he says. They can only move laterally along this girdle and collect more continents, a process seen as Gondwana became Pangaea, the team reported in November 2020 in Geology. Their model also predicts what's next for our planet. When Pangaea broke up 175 million years ago, it led to the formation of the Ring of Fire, a set of subduction zones along the perimeter of the Pacific Ocean that fuels volcanoes and earthquakes. Several continents have already combined to create the current megacontinent, Eurasia, and it has to run up against the Ring of Fire, the subduction girdle of our age. As Eurasia moves laterally along the Ring of Fire, it will eventually collide with the Americas, forming a new supercontinent in the next 50 to 200 million years, Michel says. Geologists have named this supercontinent Amasia. Although there is much debate on where Amasia will end up, Michel's model suggests it will be likely poorer, centered on today's Arctic Ocean. Before this video ends, I just want to say, I have two things to say. First of all, thank you that you're still here in the end of the video. And second of all, this is my first documentary that I made. So, don't expect that this is what each documentary will be looking like. There was not a lot of editing, unlike my videos on the main channel, because it's a documentary where you mainly have to listen. So sorry for the bad photos, bad quality photos, because I couldn't find any better photos on Google. So yeah, if you have any suggestions, please say it in the comment section below. And yeah, bye. One more thing, if it sounded like that I was reading something, yes, it is. I am reading my script. My script is in the description, and all the sources, all the information that I got is also in the description. So yeah.